Hello everyone. In today's video, I'll be introducing red cells, their structure and how it relates to their function, and also what this looks like on the blood film. We'll also take a look at how changes in different pathological conditions can be seen under the scope. Before we start, I wanted to show you what red cells look like when they are unfixed and unstained. It'll help you appreciate what they do. The clip on the right-hand side is from a wet prep. I added a drop of blood to a glass slide, put a cover slip on top, and viewed it under the microscope. I want you to focus on the immobile white cell marked by the red arrow, and look at the red cells moving past it. The red cells are extremely flexible, almost like droplets of oil, and they easily glide past the white cell. Let's start with some basic facts about red cells. See how many of them you already know. Red cells are 7 to 8 micrometers in diameter. As shown in the previous video clip, this is much larger than the capillaries through which they flow, and so they have a very flexible internal structure allowing them to squeeze through. Normal red cells are described as being biconcave in shape. This means that they are thinner in the center than they are on the outside. This also gives the area of central pallor when looking at them under the microscope. Mature red cells do not contain a nucleus, however, this is not how their journey starts. Throughout the various stages of maturation, the normal blasts become smaller until the nucleus is finally expelled from the cell, forming a reticulocyte. The reticulocytes contain mitochondria, ribosomes, and endoplasmic reticulum, which gives them the distinct blue color when viewed under the microscope. In a couple of days, the reticulocyte matures. Red cells spend approximately 120 days in circulation. Whole blood contains red cells of all ages, some of which are new, and some older, waiting to be removed. Once they have done their time, and or are damaged, red cells get removed by macrophages in the liver and spleen. The breakdown products of red cells are recycled and reused. If there are any other facts that you can think of which haven't been mentioned on this list, feel free to drop them in the comments below. Okay, now we're getting to the interesting stuff, and let's talk about the morphology of the red cells. What do they actually look like when viewed under the microscope? Normal is always a good place to start. As a rule of thumb, a normal red cell is approximately the size of the nucleus of a small lymphocyte. The bit in the middle, which looks empty in inverted commas, is known as a central pallor and should cover about one third of the cell. Colors can be subjective, but a normal red cell should be a pink salmon color. However, this may be brighter or a duller color depending on the pH of the stain used. Normal can be in terms of size, color, or shape. So here are two words that can describe it. Okay, firstly, normocytic means the red cells are of a normal size, being between 7 to 8 micrometers in diameter. On the full blood count, normocytic red cells would have a MCV, or mean corpuscular volume, of 80 to 100 femtoliters. The word used to describe the normal color of red cells is normochromic. This is linked to the amount of hemoglobin present within the cell, and so is reflected on the full blood count by the MCH and the MCHC. What if the red cells aren't normocytic and normochromic? They could be bigger or smaller in size. They could be different shapes and have different amounts of hemoglobin within them. What does that look like and how would we describe it? Smaller than normal red cells are described as being microcytic. The diameter is less than 7 to 8 micrometers and their mean corpuscular volume is less than 80 femtoliters. If you look at the image on the right hand side, you will notice a lot of the red cells are smaller than the nucleus within the lymphocyte. When the red cells are larger than normal red cells, they are described as being macrocytic. You can see some quite large cells in the image on the right. If a blood film has red cells that are both big and small, then that would be described as red cell anisocytosis. On the full blood count, anisocytosis can be inferred from a high red cell distribution width, or RDW. We spoke earlier about how red cells that are normally hemoglobinized appear. Hyperchromic is when there is less hemoglobin within the cells and they have much larger areas of central pallor. Polychromasia refers to the bluish appearance of the red cells. As mentioned earlier, these blue red cells are in fact reticulocytes and not mature erythrocytes. When red cells lose their biconcave shape due to pathological conditions or artifactual in vitro phenomenons, they are described as poikilocytes. Poikilocytes can come in a whole range of different shapes. Here are some poikilocytes. We'll go into more detail about them in a different video on another day. You'll have a short while to guess what each one is before the answer is displayed. If there are any which aren't in the images, feel free to mention that in the comments below. Are you ready? Okay, let's go. The main function of red cells is to carry oxygen from the lungs to all tissues and then to bring back carbon dioxide. The cell is structured in such a way that helps to perform this function. For example, the lack of nucleus and organelles means more oxygen can be carried. The flexibility of the red cell allows it to fit through extremely narrow capillaries. In conditions where the cellular structure is changed, for example sickle cell disease, the flexibility is affected and the sickled cells can get stuck in narrow blood vessels. This can be extremely painful for the patient. We will look at the abnormal changes red cells can go through in detail in another video. Thank you for watching the video. If you found it enjoyable and informative, please do give a thumbs up, and if you loved it, hit the subscribe button below.